C'est bon.
Hey.
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 Je
vous
bénis. Je la base de
sous
Zunkiliba.
Reprends Joseph. Reprends Joseph.
My name is Japhet Omojua. I blog, I write columns for a couple of newspapers. I'm also a public speaker and sometimes a farmer. Poultry, eggs and poultry meat, broilers. I think that you cannot judge any government out of context. The reality of Nigeria, the reality of the global economy has changed since the change of government. Actually, just before the change of government, since 2014, the price of oil has been dwindling, commodity prices have gone down, Nigeria's forex income has gone down drastically. Last month, we were able to make just $600 million, just under $600 million, one of the lowest in over 10 years. That's the reality. That is not to say, of course, that the government couldn't have done things better. I think, for instance, the cabinet was formed too late, really, really late. That could have been a major difference. But the truth of the matter is, Nigeria cannot live outside of the global reality. And the global reality is that in places like Kuwait, there are sackings and reductions in salaries and allowances. In places like Doha, there are sackings. Up to 2,000 people were sacked by the Doha oil company. In places like Saudi Arabia, there are reductions in public benefits. In places like Venezuela, you don't even want to talk about that. That is a wild west world. These are all oil economies. Apart from oil economies, commodity economies are also dwindling. It then means that our government in Nigeria has to start thinking differently, which they seem to be doing. But understandably, Nigerians are impatient because, let's face it, the APC campaign overpromised. And in overpromising and against the reality of our dwindling fortunes globally, they are, of course, under-delivering. But we cannot deny our reality as Nigerians. We are coming from a place of unprecedented corruption. Only recently, the government released numbers. And they are not even close to anywhere. They are not anywhere close to the real numbers that were stolen from Nigeria over the past 5 or 6 years. We are coming from a place where, for instance, the Minister of Power and Housing, of Power Works and Housing, said that contractors had not been paid for over 3 years, which then means that we will start to pay them for debt owed before we begin to talk about paying them for new projects. We're in a very, very bad place, Nigerians. Let us not deceive ourselves. If we expect magic, we'll only continue to live in a situation where we'll continue to be disappointed by those who govern us. What we can do is continue to demand for good governance. Good governance that demands accountability, good governance that demands transparency, good governance that puts the responsibility on those in government to always make sure to tell us the truth at every point in time. But the other truth is this one that we can see by ourselves. Things will not change overnight. It will take a lot of commitment by those in the system, a lot of commitment by Nigerians themselves to go through the pains. The era of government doing everything for us has to end. The era of government trying to do everything has to end. We must understand that the best economies, the most developed economies, the economies where innovation and creativity thrive, are economies where private individuals and private companies help to build the economy, rather than have the government continue to try to do everything. We must begin to think differently from what we were taught in primary school. We were taught that government is supposed to provide everything, from even feeding us, to clothing us, to building roads, to building hospitals, to owning businesses, airports, hotels, airlines. That era has to end. We are in the era where private money, both within Nigeria and money without from foreign investors, help to build economies. These are the things we must begin to think of, we must begin to do. The government on its side must understand that even though it cannot control certain things like the global price of oil, it can control this particular thing. It can control the ease of doing business in Nigeria. So we must stop the era of unnecessary tax breaks to cronies and associates of government. It must open up a level playing field for everyone. you must ensure that it is not so difficult for Nigerians to register their businesses as it is today. You must ensure that the Corporate Affairs Commission is not an impediment in the development and growth of new businesses. We must ensure the removal of multiple tax systems and also make sure to capture our tax base, because the truth of the matter is many Nigerians are still not captured in the tax system. When we do these and several other things, I think we can begin to truly reform our economy and make our society truly prosperous, not just for a few or those in government, but for indeed most Nigerians. For the state government, the reality is Abuja's allocation will continue to come, but in the foreseeable future, it will continue to dwindle. So it means that you have less and less overtime to get from Abuja. Governments like that of Lagos, governments like that of Kaduna are thinking differently. Governments like that of even Zamfara are looking to commit to girl child education, to enrollment of children in schools, to reversing the unfortunate numbers that say that Nigeria has one of the highest number of children out of school. They are also looking to raise money internally via internally generated revenue. This is the way to go. The era of Abuja feeding everyone has to end. We must look at our federal structure and look to restructure it. It just doesn't work as it is. We must look at our policing system, restructure it, because it does not work as it is. We must look at Nigeria as a federal structure and understand and accept that it just does not work as it is. One center cannot feed everyone. We must devolve power, we must make the state a lot more responsible, and also just as important, we must learn to elect leaders that understand business. Leaders that know that the state has to be run as a business rather than as a system where people are rewarded for doing nothing and where those that do something are punished for doing something. A state that punishes vices, rewards virtues, rewards business people, and rewards those that create value and those that create business opportunities. It's very difficult for me to advise people that have been sacked, because I've never been in that situation. But what I would say is this, that my understanding is there are many ways to prosperity. So if you've been stopped from moving forward, say in a bank or in a company where you work for, you have to understand that that is not the only way to prosperity. There are other ways. You can look to get another job. You can look at our society and ask yourself, what difference can you make? Are you good at making shoes? Can you paint or draw? Can you make shirts? Can you make suits? Can you buy and sell? There is always something to be done in an economy of 170 million people. There is definitely always something to be done. Of course, there are always challenges, but in spite of government, there are people that are making it in Nigeria. And I think with time and commitment and perseverance and persistence, I think these people can have better stories to tell in the future from this unfortunate reality of sackings by banks and other institutions. I think it's too early to talk about 2019. We must avoid a situation where we live from election to election. So one election comes, just a few months after the election, a new government is in, and we're talking about the next election. I will not advise Nigerian youth with respect to 2019. I will advise them with respect to the current administration to make sure that they force their way into system of government, to make sure that they find a space for themselves. Nobody is going to hand us power. We must demand for power. We must get it. We must show that we can be different by showing capacity, competence, and by showing that we have better character than those that have led this country in years before. When we do that, we'll be then better positioned to be amongst the big players for not just 2019 elections, but subsequent elections. But we must avoid living from election to election. Governance and democracy is about what we demand of government and what we commit to making our society work every single day, not just for elections. There are better ways to demand for justice without destroying livelihood, without killing people. I think that never in any place in the world has war and violence brought about peace. We can always have conversations on development. Everybody in Nigeria, every ethnic group, everybody in Nigeria has something to say about injustice and marginalization. Nobody can say they are the only ones that have been marginalized or the government has been unjust to. We must look at ways of restructuring the Nigerian system, because of course the Nigerian system just doesn't work. Those that were rewarded by the previous government from the Niger Delta became billionaires, but the people that were affected by the oil exploration continue to die. They continue to have their waters polluted. They continue to have their means of livelihood destroyed. So the era of rewarding a few because they are able to carry guns, because they are able to bomb a few places, must end. The government must look at a holistic and robust way to fix the Niger Delta. I have to give credit to the current Minister of Environment, Mrs. Amina Mohammed, for the beginning of cleanup of the Niger Delta. We must now go ahead, look at other ways of making sure that the people thrive. The people, not just a few privileged militants.
Okay. Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
C'est bon.
Hey.
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 C'est
bon.
C'est bon. J'ai mis Benji la base, non, sous une
salle.
Zoom Kiliba. Zoom Kiliba.
Reprends Joseph.
Again, again.
Reprends Joseph.
Hey.
Reprends Joseph.
Hey.
Reprends Joseph.
To be the best, oh. Rebrand yourself and help yourself make better rest, oh. Rebrand yourself and help yourself, my brother lady. Rebrand yourself and help yourself, my sister lady.
Kolobo, mi se bi, Kolobo, mi se bi.